I would like to draw your attention to the fact that the entire forebrain, including the occipital temporal areas and occipital lobe itself, are in supratentorial position, which is to say that they are above tentorium cerebelli. Here's tentorium cerebelli on each side. This is tentorial notch, where the brainstem would pass to enter the infratentorial position here, which is in fact situated in posterior cranial fossa. The brainstem and cerebellum have been removed from the specimen, as you can see here, and this would be the negative image, so to speak, of posterior cranial fossa, which is ordinarily filled by the cerebellum and the brainstem traversing here. And this happens to be a mid-sagittally cut specimen as well, so I can move this half of the brain out and show you the situation even more three-dimensionally. Tentorium cerebelli with the tentorial notch. Falx cerebri coming down here. And then most of the rest of the dura mater covering the hemisphere. For further clarity, I have cut the dura mater that was originally covering this side. Therefore, we get a very nice representation again. This is the Falx cerebri coming down between the two hemispheres. And then we can observe tentorial notch again, one on each side, in fact. This is where the brainstem would pass. Tentorium cerebelli itself, the entire forebrain, once again, would be superior to it. And I can certainly put the other half of the brain back here to demonstrate this point. Once again, this is tentorium cerebelli, and then the infratentorial compartment that is filling posterior cranial fossa inferior to it. And once again, by moving this hemisphere out of the way, we just look around and get a view from the various perspectives.